Hey guys, this is Frank, and I just want to do a follow-up on the battery that I built for my lawnmower. It works, but not as well as I thought it should. There have been some issues with charging and balancing, and the BMS that I have right now just isn't working. So I'm going to kind of show you the battery, kind of walk through some of the things that I think is the issue, and I'm going to just start doing some testing on it to learn from the process and see if there's something I can do to make the battery better. I have been able to mow my lawn a couple times with it, and the first time I was successful. It went all the way through, but then when I went to look at the battery, it was like dead. One of the cell banks was like really low. So I quickly charged it up and everything worked fine. It didn't seem to have damaged that cell bank, but it just wasn't balanced correctly, even though I had charged it correctly at the beginning. And I think it has to do with the BMS, or it may be a bad cell or two in that one bank. So let's take a look at the battery itself. Okay, so this is the BMS itself here, and that I have, and I don't know for sure that it's actually bad, but it just doesn't seem to be functioning correctly. If I look at, see if I can turn on my charging unit so you can see, this is now fully charged. I think that's a good angle for you to see these volts. And if we look at each of these cells, let me take that over to one more so you can see the actual. So this is 4.0706, and then if I go over to this cell here, this cell set, 4.0708, I mean, it's close, it's not exact where I want it. So here's 4.7, so that's good. I gotta turn this here so I can see. Then this cell bank here, 4.6, 4.7, so that's close. And this one here, 4.7 again, that's good. Hi, Ophelia. And we have this one here is 4.6. So we're all getting right in there, 4.6, 4.7. It's looking really good, you know, 4.6 there. This cell bank here, 4.6 again. And then this one here is the one I've been having grief with. It's down to 3.96. It's only a few point volts below what everything else is, but it's really, they should all be right spot on. And that's 4.17, which is technically a 4.2. So that's like max voltage that you'd want to go on the cells. So I have this cell bank here that is not, for whatever reason, the charging just is not consistent. And I've used my balance charger and actually have balanced each of these. I run through each of these cell sets and charge them independently and get them all perfect. I can go out and I can mow. The mower works great. Lasts for the entire yard. Come back in and I can see that the battery's drained. But this one cell set just keeps getting hit. When I recharge it, it just doesn't seem to be right. And I'm thinking it might be the BMS, or it could be a cell in this set. And the way I'm going to do the BMS first because that's kind of a simple piece. The next one to check each of the cells is I would disconnect each of these solder joints on the positive side over here and then check each cell independently, because right now if I check any of these, if I go down through any of them, they're all going to show basically what the bank has in it. If I have one bad cell, that one cell will still show, you know, it'll appear like it's good because the rest of them are all carrying the weight. And so I just need to really narrow that down to figure out why that one cell bank is not charging correctly and why this one is overcharging. To me, that would indicate that it's the BMS, that it's not doing a balance function and it's not functioning the way I think it should. Other than that, mowing went fine. I was able to mow without any issues, other than that first day when I don't know what happened. It literally took me all day to mow my lawn because I was charging this battery and charging my lead acid batteries and switching them out, and it just took forever and it was crazy. So I'm gonna just take a minute here. Let me plug in my soldering iron. I'll let this get hot and we will I'm going to go through and remove these leads and replace this BMS. So here we go. We'll get to work on this. All right. So I've gone through and worked out my leads. I had to go through and redo all my leads to go from this old BMS, which I think is my issue, but I'm not positive. This is just going to be the first step in this whole process of checking to see what the issue is with that one cell bank, or actually I had a couple cell banks. One's overcharging, one's undercharging. So I'm switching BMSs, and I went through and started the soldering process, and I was filming it, and the battery on my camera died, and so I wasn't able to show you the fact that I cross-touched the lead and had a big explosion. It was a light show, but camera didn't catch it, so you guys don't get to see it. But I enjoyed it. It was fun. Okay, so what we have here is I need to go through, before I go plugging this, my new leads into the BMS, I need to validate that they're soldered correctly so that I don't hurt the BMS. And part of that process, I'm just going to wedge this negative lead in here so I can check each of the cells. So how this BMS or BMSs work is they have the lead here has multiple pins, and starting with the black wire over here on this side going across, I'll call that pin 1, 2, 3, 4. There's 10 of them for this pack. And the way it works is the black wire, pin 1, goes to the negative, and then pin 2 goes to positive. And so if I touch the positive over here, it's 4 volts. And then if I go to pin 3, which is over on this side, it goes to 8 volts, and so on and so forth. So what I need to do though is validate that they are correct on here before I go plugging into the BMS. And the way I do that is I have a wire here. Here it is. I need to just use a pin because these pins are so small in here. So I'm going to start by going into pin 2 here, and then I'll just touch this, and it shows that, so pin 1 to pin 2 is 4 volts, and that is correct. And then if I go to pin 3, it should go to 8 volts, and it does. And then we go to pin 4, and that's 12 volts. And I just need to walk through each of these. We should have increments of about 4 volts each. 16. And there's 20. Tiny, tiny pins. 24. So what, 28? Yeah, 28, 4. Looks good. And 32. Next one is 36. And the last one should be 40, roughly 40. Yep, 40.7. Okay, so my leads are all done correctly, and it looks like everything's in order there. So now I can actually plug this into the BMS, and I will heat up some hot glue and mount this down so it's a permanent fixture, and I'll do some cleanup of the cabling so it lays a little neater. But other than that, the other thing I wanted to show you is on this BMS, it was a little different than the previous one. This one has different connections. There's a B negative, which goes to the battery. It connects into the battery itself, the negative pole in the battery. Then there's a C negative, which is the negative part of the charging side. So this is now my charging cable, and it will do the charging. So the charge current will flow through here and then into the battery. Actually, it flows in the other direction, but that's the current piece there. Then there is P negative, which is going to be the load. It's going to be the item I'll be running. This will be plugging into the lawnmower itself. And I put different ends on here so I didn't confuse them. One of them is charge and the other one is load, or going to the lawnmower itself. So I had to do that. The other BMS actually shared, it didn't have a charge lead, it just had a P, and so the P shares that responsibility of charge, and this one here runs a little separate. And I think it, because this one here, I'm hoping, if any of you have experience with this or know the answer to it, I think it's because this one actually has true balance properties in it, and it does battery balancing, and that's why it has a separate lead is so that it can actually move the charging appropriately. So I'll do some more testing on it and then I'll report back. I don't know that I'm going to spend a ton more time on lawnmower stuff. I have other projects I want to work on, and this one here was one I just needed because I needed a lawnmower and I just thought it'd be fun. So now we get to move back on to the portable power pack and moving into solar and some other things that need to be, and the power wall. I mean, I got all these batteries. I got to start building my power wall, and we'll just have to keep doing updates on that and see how that goes. That's going to be kind of fun. I'm actually looking forward to that. All right, with that, I'm going to call it. I just appreciate your time. Have a good one.